which is good money. And this first meetup of Delhi Mumbai group. And I've been the first victim, the first speaker with a very off-speed topic today. But before I start that, just a quick introduction about myself. Who am I? I'm in the software development for like the last 10 years. I've been given C-Sharp on the most valuable professional award for my excellent contribution. I'm very active in outside community contribution in terms of writing for magazines and writing articles. I'm a very active member of a Delhi Developer Day meetup, which happens every month, or I would say sometimes at least twice a month. It's primarily in Noida, and next meetup we're going to host at Microsoft Home Office on 6th December. So if you guys want to join. And apart from that, I speak at various conferences across Delhi NCR, and this is my second visit as a speaker to this talk. So thank you for calling me again. So this is the talk that I am present in front of the non-Microsoft community, which is Microsoft Open Source System with cross-platform support for mobile development. Before I start, anyone in the audience has worked on any Microsoft technology before? Which one?
Not yet. Visual Basic.
Visual Basic.
C-Sharp.
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 Cool. So like, good number of audience has worked on Microsoft systems, so it's not an alien world. But yeah, now you guys, we are working on different platforms like Android or iOS. So, when we say Microsoft, what does that strikes into your mind? What do you think about
when Closed source.
Closed source. Very true. What else?
Too complicated.
Okay. I may agree or not agree. Okay.
Blue screen of death.
Sorry?
BSOD. Blue screen of death.
BSOD. Okay. Cool.
C++ layer.
C++ layer. Okay. Anything else? Okay. One thing I would like to mention is the cost for developing. That's like the biggest thing. Whenever I talk to the guys who work in, on the open source technologies, many of those have mentioned that their companies, of course, Microsoft products involve cost to a good extent. That's why people chose to go to some other platform, like Ruby, and there are many other open source platforms. So, yeah, in past, many recent development has happened in the Microsoft world. So my talk is split across two models. One is Microsoft Open Source, and second is the mobile feature of that. So have you heard of a Connect conference that happened in New York mid of this month? Anyone has ever heard of? So Connect conference was connected by Microsoft at their New York office, and it was an awesome conference. There were like outstanding announcements. I was watching it live on Channel 9, Microsoft channel. I spent my 2 nights watching that complete live. So there were like phenomenal announcements that Microsoft conducted or announced that day. And in first week of this month, I was at Microsoft Tech in Bangalore. So what I captured from these two conferences is basically Microsoft focusing on two things. One, mobile first and cloud first approach. So mobile first, you all guys are mobile developers. We also develop mobile apps on say Windows Phone or Phone Gadget or use some other type of stuff. But Microsoft now is focusing a lot on the mobile world as well as the cloud first approach. And their cloud as well is Azure. So this is my key takeaway from that conference. And there are some news that I want to share from that conference. So the first logo by Microsoft director was .NET for every developer now, and for every application. Now you can develop everything on .NET itself. I will showcase some code to you. .NET is now open source, is completely available. The source code is completely available. I can sorry. I'm still not. So this is like the .NET code base, .NET foundation, the whole code of .NET is now open source. So .NET system is no longer a closed system. Microsoft has released it. They understand, like, open source community is very good, and Microsoft wants to keep up with the development world. So it's now completely open source. Second big announcement is ASP.NET VNet. And anyone has heard of ASP.NET VNet? Maybe not. So you guys know MVC, right? So in .NET, there's also an MVC pattern. So their next generation of MVC, they call it as VNet. I have written a few articles on this, open a couple of meetups on this. Now they have changed it into .NET 5. And it's also open source. The whole code base is released on GitHub. So now if you guys want, you can fork it, you can download the code, you can submit the changes. So it's no longer a closed territory. As Achal mentioned, like, it's a closed territory. So that pain point, what people or what developer used to relate to Microsoft, is passing now. Next is Microsoft loves Linux and OS X. This is what I picked exactly from Satya Nadella's point. So far, if we develop anything on .NET, it used to just work for Windows Server, right? Like, if we work in Windows, Ruby can work in your Linux, Ruby can work on iOS, right? You have WebRail, MongoDB, Nginx, different kind of servers. Now, Microsoft is also providing the same capability to make your code run on any platform. And it's absolutely free. I will show you .NET Cobra on OS X. And next is, you guys know Visual Studio?
Yes.
I hope everybody knows. Do you think it's a good editor? If you have
heard of it, it's pretty much.
Yeah, good. So, yeah, it is of course very powerful editor. And so far it is like very highly priced, even I think so. My company gives me license, otherwise it's very hard to work on this awesome editor. This is not free. Visual Studio Microsoft has made free. Okay, you can go at this link. Everything you need to create great apps is free. Now you can download Visual Studio Community 2013 edition and it's free of cost. There is nothing you need to pay to Microsoft. You can enjoy the full capability of Visual Studio free of cost. So, how do you think, you know, what these announcements are? Are these cool?
Why is it here?
Yeah, that's a good question. I think what I can, although I have not been in that conference in the app, what I can perceive is maybe Microsoft wants to attract more developer community to this platform. I see that as the biggest push. I read somewhere like there are 6 million .NET developers across the globe, which is like 60 lakh. So I don't know how much number anybody has quantified in terms of open source developers, but I think Microsoft main push behind all these things is making and attracting larger developer pool to Microsoft.
So they would still charge for support, but deployments are
maybe. I don't know that much about it. I've never explored it. But these are the very recent announcements that I'm just sharing with you guys. Because you guys are very insulated from the Microsoft world. And then Visual Studio 2015 as well, which they have launched in the paper world. So this is in terms of the announcements, right? It looks very fancy and cool. So I will just talk a minute about .NET 5, ASP.NET 5. So this is a grounded up platform which Microsoft has created. They have taken away their whole bunch of .NET framework, so you don't need to have your .NET framework running on your operating system to run any website. Whatever you will make in your website, you can have the mini framework inbuilt into that. So it is pretty lean. So you don't need IX, you don't need IX Express. So I just this thing always there. I'll come back on this. So I will run .NET code on my Mac machine. I will just tell you. You guys know Homebrew?
Yes.
Way better than me. So there's a company called Xamarin which provides Mono framework. And Microsoft and Xamarin has kind of partnered. Now they are providing solutions so that .NET can work. on OS X and can work on Linux. So this is all the installations that I have done so that .NET can work on my machine. So I will not run all this stuff because I've already done this installation. I will show you the end of it. So just talking more about .NET 5. So it's open source. I just show you a bit of it. And cross-platform support. So as I said, earlier Windows means only restricted to Windows. There is no other platform that Windows 4 used to work with. Now it can work on OS X. So let's see some demo.
And just a question, when you say open source, that is great, but who owns the commit right? Are they going to give it to the community outside of Microsoft?
Yes, I think, yeah, that's a good question. So I was chatting with their very senior engineer, David Powell. So if the process is there defined on GitHub, this code is available, you can download it. So it's a safe fashion, like you do in Ruby, I think. Few of my friends are Ruby contributors.
No, being a contributor is something, but having the commit right, the guys who actually define the direction of the framework are the guys who have the commit right. You may contribute 100 things, but they won't merge it upstream.
Yeah, so I think that's still up to their jurisdiction. So you can fork it, you can submit the stuff, and I think, I mean, I never did that. So. But there's some process being defined and written. You can just go through that link. So they mentioned it over there. But I think surely if they think something is good that someone has contributed, I think they will adopt it.
That's one thing. The other thing is, who are these guys who would own the commit rights? Because they'll define the direction where the framework goes.
Okay. So
it might be too early for us, but that is the thing that would matter more than just making open source.
Right, I think I don't have much idea. So, their standards and everything are available on GitHub. I think on channel line. So, Scott Hansen, my who is leading this .NET 5 effort. Maybe I think if someone is really keen on that level, you can just exchange some Twitter messages or just can chat with these guys. Right? The core .NET 5 team. Alright.
So the point was that core has to move outside of Microsoft.
I got it. Maybe I don't have much media. So.
And it's good.
Yes.
If you're just open source.
Right. So, okay, shall I move on?
Not sure.
So. What I've done is I have created few samples of .NET application. It's all .NET code and I will run it here. I will just show you the code first. So let me open Sublime.
Is there a Visual Studio for Mac?
Not yet, but I think these guys are working for that. They are, as I said, they are partners in it. So till that time, as a stopgap solution, if you want to write .NET code on Mac, you can use Sublime. You can use only Sharp editor. So Mathmal, I will show you few capabilities of Visual Studio is now available in Sublime. So you can run a build command. You can build the code. You can run server. From here, so let me just show you guys. So this is all dotted code, right? And this is Microsoft.php.net.mc. This is all in the OSX. And this is basically a new way of writing .NET MVC. It's pretty much in line with like write for your build file or your bower.json. So it's more or less like this. Now in OSX, we don't have any IIS Express. It's not a Windows directory, right? So it, what Microsoft has done, it is now provided with their own self-hosting server. Now they have their own self-hosting server, which you can run the .NET application from there itself. So in Sublime, I have installed a package for Culture. So using Culture, you can do some commands, you can do some magic. So if I want to run a build, then this build will trigger. So this has now built my .NET application. Again, show you something. So this is all .NET code that is being built on Mac operating system. I think last year even I could never imagine .NET working on Mac operating system like this. Now we want to run the website. Yes. So there is this Omnisha package. I have not done that setting in my Mac, but I will do. I will download this Omnisha. After that, you can do this dot, this whole intelligence that will be added in your Sublime itself. So your Sublime kind of, apart from that debugging capability and some other thing that Visual Studio offers, you can use Sublime to a very good extent to do a .NET development.
But hasn't Mono been around for years now?
Yes.
At least I saw it 5 years ago.
Yes, yes. That's a good question. Yeah, so Mono being around and Xamarin had their own IDE as well, but I think the world never got that much attention on Mono till the time Microsoft actually partnered with them, right? And now they agreed, okay, let's go hand in hand. And because so far, I think Microsoft approach is only to be in their own silos, to be in their own world.
Because the Groovy, there has been Iron Groovy which runs with Mono and they've been around for 5-6 years.
Yeah. So the Xamarin company is being into this cross platform stuff for a long time, as you said. Iron Groovy, right? Right, sometimes Iron Groovy, but I never, you know, got the hands ready into it. Yeah, it's been there, but I think recently they got this attraction because of this. Microsoft actually getting into cross platform mode. Alright, so they have this A server. Their server name is Kestrel. Like you have Webbrick, Mongrel, Nginx. So for Mac, there is an A server now, which you can use to run the .NET apps. So all those steps that I did for Mongrel and all that, so those steps, I installed this K server. And now what I can do is, I have also downloaded a node package for NodeMon. What it does is, it dynamically helps in compiling. So in Ruby, right, if I ask you guys, if you make any change in your RB file and you put it on the server, you don't need to restart your server, right? You can just directly do F5 and your files are ready. Or you need to restart your web server.
It depends on what kind of server.
Okay.
And what mode are you running Rails in? So there's a development mode where every file is reloaded. There you don't need to do anything. But if you're running on production, you have to restart the server.
Or reload it is different for every server.
Yeah. So far in your .NET, I think if you guys know, if we make any code change into CS file we used to build, it generates the DLL and then we need to put that DLL into the server. But now with this .NET 5, they have come up with a Roslyn compiler. They are calling it Roslyn. This does not generate DLL. Okay. Whatever compilation happens, it happens in memory. So it's all dynamic compiling, it happens in memory only.
Is it slower?
No, it's not. And you don't need to necessarily restart your server as well. You make a code change, go to browser like you do JavaScript. You press F5 and your code is up there. So I will show you as so let's go to that directly. written a script. So this is, I am using one node packet or node mod. What it is doing, it is picking up a Kestrel server command. I will show you what this run.sh is. But there is a Kestrel server that Microsoft has. Now the server is started. So this is like your WebRay or IIS, whatever. And what I will do is, I will go to my browser. And over here, let us see what my file has. So I have defined the Kestrel server and the URL. So I can host multiple websites with different ports from my same application. So when I say this, I mean I have this web server, this works in Windows, and this Kestrel server, this works in OSX or your Linux variant. So I can host different, same website under different port numbers, under different servers using this.
So what is Kestrel for?
Yes, so Kestrel is a sublight package. So if you have a good sublight,
okay.
So it's just a package. So this is the URL, and so my Kestrel server is running. So hello, friends. So ASP.NET is a free web framework for building these apps. So this is like .NET working on OSX. Without Visual Studio, without IIS, without IIS Express, right? And this is, I just did it in Sublime. Now you can ask me how I have come up with this .NET code. So either I have created all controllers, models, views, everything at my home, or I did some kind of scaffolding, right? So what I have done in Sublime, but here Microsoft has given me different features like you can, you know, use Power, build, Power install, right up here from the, I don't know how much visible it is, but I may zoom it. But the idea is you can enjoy all those capabilities right from the Visual Studio editor, and it will be free for all developers. So maybe wherever it will hit the ground on other platforms, I think Visual Studio may give more attraction. So that's the thing, things are same. If you can just run it. And if you run the IIS Express and run this scaffold application, you can run via command prompt like kweb, what I have done in OSX, like kkestrel. You could do kweb in Windows if you want to run via command prompt server. So, right, so it's cloud ready. I can just tell you one of the very cool features over here is. If you want to publish your website, you can directly do to Microsoft Azure. So they are giving this native capability. You can directly publish this website to your Azure. So I did this publish, for example, I think I have a sample for you. Like this website. So I published this website directly from my Visual Studio to Azure system because it takes some time to move the content. And the website is up running directly from. So cloud, mobile, and this all open source is knitted together with what I understand from Microsoft perspective now. Alright, so this is next time when I will demo you. So this is the Android emulator that will work from Visual Studio. Just for your reference, I captured the picture for now. iOS has not captured, unfortunately, but this is how Android emulator will look like. An familiar Android emulator, which will work from Visual Studio. Right. So just summary, .NET open source system, no more dependency on IIS, IIS Express, building code on the fly, cross-platform support, editor of your choice, cloud support, and host application offline Windows. So this is at least my takeaway from so far what has been announced by Microsoft. And if you guys are interested, you can explore this directly as a polyglot. And I explored a lot of content, and also I have done some stuff in Ruby as well. So
can you just explain the last one, most application outside?
Yes. So it's like I was running through this kkestrel. So you can host, you can run your website on.
Even on production, you would it
have any. So currently it's all in beta, but it will be available in production phase.
Yeah.
So I think that will be a very cool achievement. Because currently for Windows,
when you compare it to WebRig, you would never use WebRig for production.
Okay, I mean, I have not done that comparison. You use mobile or engine server?
Usually engine.
Usually with
MLK interpreter. I was saying MLK interpreter.
Okay.
Usually it's
in
Nginx. Also, increasingly people are using Puma.
Okay, I heard Nginx. So, as cross-platform, we can learn a lot from each other's technology or from different technologies. Like Microsoft can learn a lot from Ruby, a lot from Python, I can tell you. Their DLR concept or other concept. Like Ruby 8 can be seen pretty popular. So, as programmers, we should just try to learn whatever happening good in other streams. So, right, if you want to take a look, if you want these links, I can share with you. I have written many articles and for some entrants I have written on .NET, VNext. So, if you want to give you these links, you can just refer it. Or you can go to C#Bama, find my profile over there. There are a lot of articles. You can just go through that. Guys, thank you so much. Please share the feedback of very open, very kindly. And it's an off-bit topic in Ruby directly or iOS directly, but I just tried.
I think we can actually share these slides on the video.
Sure. I will just send you the link. Okay, guys, thank you.
Thank you.